In this Kelvin double bridge method, you are adding one of the ratio arm, that is P upon Q, small P upon Q. So one arm is added, so it is called double bridge. And here R is the sliding wire resistance, and other are the known resistance except capital R. Okay. So here you are getting the diagram, circuit diagram of Kelvin double bridge, which already explained to you. If any doubt in the understanding of circuit diagram, please ask. The galvanometer should be connected in between F and H. Here F and H are the nothing but node terminals. Okay, you can give other name also, 1, 2, 3, 4 like this, or alphabet, suitable alphabets you can use. For understanding point of view, we are giving the name here. F and H will get the equipotential point when there is a no current flowing through the galvanometer. By varying S, you are getting the null deflection in the galvanometer. Now in this Kelvin double bridge, once you are giving supply to the battery or with the help of EMF source, the current will flow through it and galvanometer shows some deflection, right? Because of its presence of current. Then second thing, you have to vary this standard variable resistance S to get the null deflection. So F and H will become equipotential points. So you can write which step? You can write the voltage drop across this capital P is equal to the voltage drop across capital R plus small p. So I have shown that expression here. Likewise, right? This is equation number one. Okay. Any doubt in equation number one, please ask. The voltage drop across capital P is equal to voltage drop across capital R and small p. So this is your equation number one. V is equal to IR. That concept is used here. So I1 into P. P is a resistance. Capital R is a resistance, and small p is also resistance. Here capital R is the unknown resistance. Okay. And I1 and I, these are the current. As per the, we can say, we are giving the names. You can give other names also. Here this is the second step. Similarly, you are getting the voltage drop across Q is equal to drop across capital S and small q. This will become equation number two, right? So this is very simple concept in comparison with the previous concept. The previous concept is nothing but EAB is equal to EAMD they have written. That is also same, but they are using the voltage division theorem, and that is quite difficult for the student sometimes to understand. That's why I'm selecting this method. As small r is in parallel with P plus Q. Okay. So this is the known concept to you. Small r is in parallel with the P plus Q from the circuit diagram you are getting this. So you can write the voltage drop across small r and voltage drop across P plus Q is same. So VR is equal to V in bracket P plus Q. So this is nothing but I minus I2 into small r is equal to I2 into P plus Q. V is equal to IR concept is used here. How? Small r is a resistance, so it is multiplied here. The current flowing through that small r is nothing but I minus I2. I is the total current and I2 is flowing through the P, small p Q branches. That's why it is subtracted here. So I minus I2 is there. And in a V P plus Q, there is a I2 current flowing. Okay. So I2 multiplied by P plus Q. Now you please simplify this, means expanding the bracket, and you will get I2 is equal to R upon P plus Q plus R into I. Okay. If any difficulty here to solving expanding this bracket, please ask. You can ask right now, or you can ask next time after practicing. Okay. Now substitute this value of I2 in equation 1 and 2. So you will get equation 3 and 4. Likewise. Now it is very clear to you. It is like now Wheatstone's bridge. You can take the ratio 3 by 4, similar to Wheatstone's bridge. And
Again, you are going to simplify. Those are common parts, you will eliminate them. Here I1 is common and here I is common. So it will be divided here. Now P upon Q is equal to R plus in bracket RP upon P plus Q plus R divided by S, S plus in bracket QR upon P plus Q plus R. Okay. This is your whole expression, right?
If any difficulty to understand up till this, please ask. So shall I continue now? Next expression.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Here I have written the conclusions and the last step, which is simplified.
Now, P upon Q in bracket, S plus QR upon P plus Q plus R, these are all small case, is equal to R plus PR upon P plus Q plus R. Here you are getting the terminology QR upon P plus Q plus R common. Once you are transferring from LHS to RHS, right? So as you are taking Q common, so U should be divided here. Here it is divided, okay. R capital R is equal to P upon Q into S plus QR upon P plus Q plus R. This step is common in the previous explanation also, because this is nothing but our last step. And our aim is to obtain what? Expression for unknown resistance, that is low resistance of the wire or any other, we can say, conducting material, which is going to measure with the help of this Kelvin double bridge method. So by this expression you can find it out. But the condition is what? P upon Q, capital P upon Q is equal to small p upon Q. So that ratio should be same. So what will happen? This will zero. This will become zero. And same expression which is obtained by Wheatstone bridge, we are getting capital R is equal to P upon Q into S.
From this expression, it is clear that the resistance of slide wire R has no effect on the measurement of capital R, provided that the ratio of capital P upon Q is equal to small p upon Q. Second conclusion, for accurate measurement of R, two readings are taken by reversing the direction of current through the bridge circuit. The average of these two values is taken as the magnitude of the unknown resistance. Effect of thermoelectric EMF at all junction points of the bridge circuit is cancelled by reversing the direction of current through the bridge circuit, and current R is obtained. So here you are getting the understanding how we can conclude it, right? So I am